And yes, there it is, our beautiful sector. The church is still there. It hasn't been properly decommissioned yet. But that is happening. So, without anything else, it's time to get going. First faction up this week is the Bountiful Trade Conglomerate. And what are they up to? So, expand this. They are going to do plenty of things this round. So, as their action, they are going to use their asset ability, and then they are going to use plenty of assets. Venture capital is going to... one venture capital is going to do its thing. And venture capital, they generate wealth. Pretty much straight up, they generate wealth. And as an action, venture capital can be tapped. 1d8 is rolled. On a 1, the asset is destroyed. While on a 2-3, 1 fac cred, 4-7, 2 fac creds, and 8 grants 3 fac creds. So, the D8 says... Sorry. There goes your venture capital. Yeah. Dab. That is a good description. You should have invested in a Book of Secrets. That would have been very handy at this point. So... that rolled a 1. Destroyed. So... BT0001. This one no longer belongs to the Bountiful Trade Conglomerate, but destroyed. Oh, it began with a bang. Then two commodities brokers. The commodities brokers, they are a bit safer. As an action, donor commodities broker can roll 1d8. That many fact creds are subtracted from the cost of their next asset purchase, down to minimum of a half normal price. So, and there were two of them. So let's roll 2d8. A 6 and a 7, so in total 13 fact creds. Which is a substantial rebate. So Bountiful Trade Conglomerate notes minus 13. Next purchase, and not on the church but up there. And then marketeers versus any other faction's asset in Kalia. Is there any other assets in Kalia? Forgot to clear them all. The only assets in Kalia that doesn't belong to the Bountiful Trade Conglomerate are destroyed. But it was a good idea. Yeah, someone just forgot to forgot to remember that they acted first this round, and no other factions have had the opportunity to move assets into their territory. Yeah, the destroyed ship is destroyed. It belongs to the destroyed faction, and that faction is just there for me to remember that it is destroyed. And so, that was the Bountiful Trade Conglomerate. Yes, and next up this week is the Enigma Entertainment. And their action is to use asset ability. So they're going to use a Commodities Broker, a Vendor Capital, E41. Venture Capital. I thought it was that. So, Commodities Broker was a D8 and that rebate on the next purchase. One. Plenty of ones. But luckily the Digma Entertainment had that for their Commodities Broker, not their Venture Capital. If not, a second Venture Capital would have gone poof. So Digma Entertainment minus one, next purchase. And then it was the Venture Capital, another D8. Ooh. Someone shows their extreme values correctly. 8, that would be 3. Let's just double check. Venture Capital, and 8 grants 3 facreds. So Enigma Entertainment gets another 3 facreds, and they now have 28. They are rich. They are currently the wealthiest faction of them all. And then since they are mercenaries, all faction assets gain the following special ability. As an action, the asset may move itself to any world within one hex. So, they want to move Seditionists and Party Machine. So, Enigma Entertainment, Seditionists. There it is. So, I need to start to make a few notes here. So, EEO004, it's on Enigma, in the Enigma system, and it was the Party Machine. That is in the Bimacetisu system. 02, 01, 01, 02. So the Seditionists are going to move to where the Party Machine is. 0102, and the Party Machine is going to move to 0202. let's take a look at that. So the first, the seditionists that are currently on in the Enigma Entertainment Systems are going to move to be Massachusetts system. No problem there. And the party machine in BMA tissue is going to move to the Tora system. Specifically Anulakhila. So let's have a little look at what the Anulakhila. Police state and a preceptor archive. Preceptor archive is a great repository of pre-silence knowledge. So let's make these visible just for fun. And now we are going to color this. So Enigma Entertainment, Nunboy, and then we're going to shade it. So the seditionists are going to move to 0102. ISIS. And the seditionists are going to move to 0202, Anulakhila. And that was it. Oh, I need to update goals. So, bound for trade conglomerate, they are 2 out of 3 on their planetary seizure. Enigma Entertainment, likewise. So, movements have been done. Capitals have been earned. And it's time for the Flaming Dragon. Their action is a bit simpler. They are just going to buy a party machine on Admedes. And their goal is as before. Why don't I just copy this? And they are now at 2 out of 4. Party machine wealth, I believe. No, then it was a cunning. Party machine. Political blocks control particular cities or regions, blocks that are firmly in control of the faction. Each turn, a party machine provides one fact credit to its owning faction. Party machines, they are cunning four. So, Flaming Dragon, they have cunning five, so... everything okay. So, a party machine will cost 8. So, Flaming Dragon, Party Machine, and it was to be on Admedes. Flaming Dragon, turn 7, and their first purchase. Wow. The Flaming Dragon must have plenty of party machines. So, Flaming Dragon. One party machine, two party machine, three party machine, four party machine. It's a party in the Flaming Dragon. And you're probably invited as long as you pay the party fees. And that was all the Flaming Dragon was going to do, and then it's the Helix Foundation. Their goal is still to expand influence. And so far they haven't purchased that base of influence to get experience from it, but they are going to use their assets instead. Post-tech industries. I am fairly certain that's a wealth asset. Yes. As an action, the owning faction can roll 1d6 on 1. 1 fact credit is lost. On a 2-4, 1 is earned. 5-6, 2. If money is lost and no resources are available to pay it, the post-tech industry is destroyed. It's like venture capital, but safer. So, 2d6. A 6 and a 2. So, a 2, they gained 1. And a 5 to 6, 2. So they earn 3 credits from their industries. And 11 plus 3 is 14. And then they are going to use their shipping combine to move some cracked comms from Turid to Mitro Stack. Shipping combine, they do cost. Yeah, as an action, the combine may move any number of non-force assets, including itself, to any world within 2 hexes at the cost of 1 fact credit per asset. So, cracked comms. HF0501 from Turid to Mitro Stack. So let's just verify that the cracked comms are in the Helix Foundation system, and they are going to move from 03 or 02 to 02 06, 1 2. So So they are expanding there. What is it in Algird system? And the Mitro Stack. Oh, it's a tech level 2. No, tech level 0. It's a wonderful full planet. Xenophiles. Caveman Xenophiles. Primitive Xenophiles. However, they have this preceptor archive. Probably either consider it a great source of heretical and dangerous knowledge, or they worship it. So let's move it to 0206 Mitro Stack. And that costs the Helix Foundation 1, so they now only have 13. And that's it for the Helix Foundation. Unfortunately, the space company hasn't given me any action. However, there is something that is ticking up for them. So I'm that benevolent. I'm going to tick up their planetary seizure. And that was on Grod Hill. So unfortunately, the space company isn't doing anything this round, except solidifying their control of their system. And that was the last faction to do things. So, as I have written it down in big letters, pay out faction incomes. I'm paying out faction incomes. Faction incomes have been paid. Are you happy? You should be happy. You need to be happy. So, that was it. Plenty of small things happened. The Bountiful Trade conglomerate lost their venture capital. Wonderful. I'm going to relish that. That oh so beautiful natural one. Ah, what a traitor. And on that traitorous note, it's all over for this round. See you again next week. Not the same time, but same place.